the president of the United States expressing his opinion about mail-in voting, it's not the facts. The state of Washington has been doing this forever. And they have found that there's almost no fraud. You will have fraud in almost anything. I was born and raised in the Apostates. One of my first meetings, not a meeting of mine, one of my first memories was a meeting my dad was having. He was president of the presbytery when they were about to defrock a minister. They didn't burn down the church. They got rid of the minister. So you don't get rid of an election when you find fraud. You find fraud up in North Carolina. The president's own party, the guy he endorsed, committed the fraud, and he never took office. Had to put the election off forever. We just heard out in the Midwest another big fraudulent case, the president's party. Both parties may be subjected to fraud, but we should not develop our entire approach to this election based upon the possibilities of fraud. Let's put in place the kind of processes to protect that. We can do that. Congress can appropriate the necessary funds to have voting take place up to Election Day. Election Day is going to be November 3rd. There's no reason why we can't stop voting in earnest. At the same time, states start absentee and early voting. They do it for 30 days. Most states do it for 30 days. Why don't we have voting in earnest for 30 days? Why don't we put the resources in the budget so that we can say that you can vote over a period of 2, 3, 4 weeks and have all those votes? If you're gonna mail it in, have it postmarked by the Saturday before Election Day in order for the votes to count. Girl, this whole thing about nobody voting absentee until the day of election, and you're not knowing for 15, 20 days, maybe 30 days, who the winners are, you could do that proactively. It is so easy to do. And so I'm worried that we will sit back knowing full well that there's somebody trying to disrupt this election, trying not to have this election at all, and trying to install himself as a strong man. I've said this before, and a lot of people get nervous when I say it. But, you know, there's one thing about turning 80, you know, which I did last week.
Happy birthday.
You tend to say what you feel like saying, and so I'm going to say it. I don't think this man plans to have an election. I think this man thinks he's going to hoodwink the people of this country much the way that the people of Germany was hoodwinked back in the 1930s. That's what I said, that's what I believe.